Hi, everybody. I'm Mike with Lenovo, and I'm here with the ThinkCenter M73 series, which is available in three form factors. We have a tower, the small, and the tiny. Today, we're going to be replacing the memory module in the small form factor. The process will take about 15 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. The only tools required will be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we want to make sure that we're protected against electrostatic discharge, or ESD. For more information on ESD, click the link in the description. Now let's get started. First, you want to remove the two thumb screws. And then slide the cover back and lift it. Now we want to pop the clips loose on the front bezel and then open it and remove it. And we still have a cable here that goes inside. And now we need to open the drive bay assembly. We just want to open it until this latch pops and locks it open. Now we need to disconnect the power button cable from the system board. And now we have these two clips that hold the cable in place. You twist to open the clips, and then you can pull the cable out. And so now we just need to pull the front bezel away from the system and feed this cable through the hole in the chassis. And now we need to lay the system down flat on the table. Now we want to remove the screw from the tab that holds the card in place. And we want to lift the card straight up out of the slot and then pull back to get the tab out of the hole. To remove the fan duct, you pull slightly outward on the tabs and lift it straight up and out of the system. And to remove the memory module, you press outward on the clips to release it and then lift it straight up out of the slot. And here we have our new memory module in the anti-static bag. We want to go ahead and replace it in the system. And you take your replacement memory module and you align it in the slot. And you make sure that the notch is aligned with the tab. The notch in the memory module is aligned with the tab in the slot. And you press down until the edges close. And you have to make sure that the clips are snapped tight. To replace the fan duct, you just set it in place over the fan and push it straight down until the tabs snap. So to replace the card, we want to align the card with the slot and make sure the tab goes through the hole in the chassis. And once you have the card aligned, you press down until it's fully seated. And then you replace the screw in the tab to hold the card in place. So now we need to stand the system back up to put the front bezel back on. We need to feed the power button cable through the hole in the chassis and pull it all the way through. Now we gotta make sure the cable goes back into the clips and you twist the clip to close it. Now we need to reconnect the power button cable to the system board. Now we need to close the drive bay assembly. We want to press down on the blue touch point on that latch, which allows you to close it. And then you just make sure it closes all the way. And now we want to align the hinge clips with the holes in the chassis and then close the front bezel like a door. And we place the cover onto the system and slide it forward. Then replace the two thumb screws.